So very quick, like I flew. ending was also wild. Like, a few different plot twists, but, like, one, which kind of brings everything together, was just, like, what? And then I just had to start the next and final book in the series. So, yes, that was 5 stars, and then I was gonna save this till the end, but I might as well mention it right now. I have started the last book, Bad Blood, which is quite a bit chunkier. This has over 500 pages. I am on page 70, and yeah, really enjoying it. Nothing to complain about. Continuation on what was going on in the last book, but I can just tell that everything is gonna wrap up so nicely, and I can't wait. I can't wait. I'm also very sad for this series to be over. I don't want it to be over. Off of a meme, saving October for all just the Halloween thrillers, horrors, maybe a couple witchy books, but yeah, October is on hold. But by the way, this book was gifted to me from Mary, one of you beautiful subscribers. She gave it 4.5 stars. I actually gave it 4.75. Yeah, 4.5, 4.75. But, so, I read this earlier in the month. I swear, like, books that I read at the start of the month, by the time I get to recording this video, it's like I read them a year ago. But, so this book follows the main female character named Oriah. Oriah. I think is how you pronounce it. And she is a human, but this world has humans and vampires, 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 and the vampires kind of rule the land. And when she is little, her town is kind of destroyed, and she is taken by the vampire king. So she grows up being a vampire's daughter. She is very strong-willed for a human. And in her 20s, she's been kind of training for these, like, games that happen, I think, every 100 or 150 years called the Kajari. It's basically a set of four different games, and the last person or vampire at the end wins it all, wins, like, basically whatever you want, power. And so she joins this wanting to win so she can be powerful like her vampire father, and she meets a vampire man during these games. And I'll let you speculate what happens there. But I, like, while reading this, whenever I would stop, I was just so excited to get back to it. I just kept thinking about it. Yeah, it went by really fast. Like, it's almost 500 pages, but I feel like I read it super duper quickly. Easy read, very reminiscent of Hunger Games. Gave me very strong Hunger Games vibes, but, like, vampires and darker, a little bit darker than Hunger Games. Also very classic, like, fantasy. I feel like these days, like, with the Night City trials, rebels, all that sort of stuff. But I ate it up. I still loved it so much. One thing that was a little annoying, though, the main male character, because Oriah always had, like, this, like, not frown, but, like, annoyed face, kind of. So every time she would do that, he would be like, "There she is." Too many times those words were uttered, but other than that, amazing. Can't wait to finish the series. Okay, so this next book, I actually read at the start of September, so I really feel like it is not at the top of my mind, but I enjoyed it very much so. This was my August, I think, Illumicrate subscription book. This is the first, like, physical Illumicrate book, or I think any special edition that I've, like, actually physically read. And, like, I don't care if it's a special edition, I will read it. I like my books, even special edition, to be loved, you know, like, I don't care, you know. So, anyways, something about this book I just had to read, like, right away. And I'm really glad I did. is really, really, really cute. It is a like a modern fantasy, so like they have technology, they live in a city, which I really like when fantasies are kind of set in modern day. It is YA, but they're swearing. Like she, the main character Ayla, she swore like near the beginning of the video, the book. And for some reason, I'm like never expecting characters, especially in YA, to like actually say the F word. But when she did, I was like, yeah, thank you for like actually swearing and not just being like, oh gosh darn it, you know. So it's kind of nice.
See it absolutely everywhere. And honestly, for Goodreads,
engaged, and then he goes away on like his bachelorette trip and comes back to tell Daphne that his childhood best friend named Petra, who is a woman, has confessed her love for him, and he confessed his to her. So now they're together. So their engagement
start of this.
is and stuff and more in the third volume, so I won't spoil anything. But yeah, in volume 3 we learn more about this different Titan, and they try a new technique to rid the Titans and gain back some of their land. And I'm just excited to see where this can go. This is the cover of the third volume, by the way. So gross.
Odyssey
these books endless amount of times. So I actually did order them, and I want to read the Iliad and the Odyssey because I never have. Apparently some people read them in high school. My mom did, but I never did. Honestly, this might sound silly, but I didn't even know, like, I'd heard of those books, but I didn't know what they were. And now that I do, I really want to read them. So I'm really excited for that. I think this book and Natalie really helped to kind of pique my interest more in the Greek mythology field, and I'm excited to explore it more and then, yeah, maybe revisit this book in the future. So, 3 stars tentatively, again, I think just on me. So, those are all the books that I read in September. Yeah, I'm so excited for October. Let me know what books you guys have read recently, or if there are any fall ones that you were excited to get to. Last month, I read Once Upon a Broken Heart, the first in a three-book, obviously a three-book trilogy in a trilogy. I think I'm going to put that on hold until November as well to continue that trilogy, because my October is too filled, but I am very excited to get back to that trilogy. So, I think that is going to be it from me today. This video is going to be like 45-ish minutes. Let me know if you like this longer video. I tend to blab on. I'm horrible at explaining things. Like, I'm really bad at explaining. I never know how much to say or how much not to say or what to say.